Are you part of the Congressional Hispanic Caucus?
Yes.
Let me ask you something. What do you think of the fact that some corporations are funding this conference? Oil companies, bank companies like Citibank, Bank of America, Walmart, McDonald's. What do you think of that?
Well, these companies recognize the growth and the development of the Hispanic population in the United States,
okay,
and our contribution. And so I think that because of our contribution, they can't ignore this population.
Okay, what is the Hispanic community? By Hispanic, I understand that it's people from Spain or from Spanish heritage. But for what I see here, most of us are brown people or indigenous or Afro descendants. Why do you guys use the word Hispanic?
Well, I think that mostly in the United States, people are, there's a trend to use Latino. In my home, we in Colorado, I use Chicano.
Chicano.
So
but why don't we?
It depends what area you're from, but I think to include and recognize that not all. All Hispanics, all Latinos are, that we're all different when we are spoken about by the government, by others, by corporate America. They refer to us as one big
exactly.
Group,
it's like a
but we're not, and they're learning to recognize that we're not. We're
and I
different.
See you wearing some Native regalia. That's beautiful. So you value your Native American heritage, I guess.
Very, very much so. Very much my indigenous heritage.
Absolutely. So do I. I'm just wondering when this Hispanic Congressional Institute is going to do that, because I haven't heard them talking about this diversity at all.
Well, I think I heard them speaking about diversity during yesterday, during parts of the institute, the caucus that was going on in the last 2 days.
They mentioned about diversity. Well, that's something good.
Yes, they did. And I think they addressed Mexican American, the difference between the Puerto Rican Americans and just a group of people that, because I know for the Chicano women and the Chicano men, we are very vocal about our indigenous roots and about the issues that are important to us. I think this group is also very outspoken too, it's just in a different manner.
And tomorrow, you personally don't like the terms Latino or Hispanic. Why is that?
Not to refer to everybody, because I don't consider myself Latino. I am not Latino. I consider myself Chicano.
Chicano.
So I would rather than be grouped all as one with everyone, then I think that corporate America, that the government needs to recognize we're not all one big group of the same.
And when they talk about the biggest minority in the U.S., but within us, as we can see in this crowd here, we are so in different shapes and colors and cultures. Why do you think there's never that kind of conversation within our communities, for instance?
I think part of it may be that it would be so convenient for us to raise all of our differences would make it very easy for people like Rush Limbaugh and others in America who want to use the divisiveness to tear us apart and to tear whatever clout we have together as common people to come together. And I think that it would be used, unfortunately, very strongly against us.
Well, why you...
Thing of divide and conquer.
Well, yes, but we can be united still if we recognize our true identities.
Yes,
you know,
and I think that's up to us to do
absolutely
that, and not to let people tear us apart.
You see, if African Americans, white people, Asian, Native Americans, Hispanics, whatever we want to be, it's important that our people know what we really are.
That's true.
Especially the youth.
Yes, it's very true. I was married, I'm no longer, but I was married to a Puerto Rican man, and so I have 3 children, and they are combined Mexican-American and Puerto Rican, and they are very proud of both parts of their ethnic background, and so to call them Puerto Rican is not correct, to call them Latino is not correct, to call them Mexican-Americans are not correct.
What will they mark in the 2010 census? What would you mark?
I would mark them as, probably would depend on what the options are
I will mark American Indian.
If it had it to mark, if it had a way to write it in, then I would probably write in exactly what they want.
Because there is an option, American Indian.
A lot of people would mark American Indian.
That I would.
I know a lot of people would mark.
And you're here for the Congressional Hispanic Caucus Institute event, right?
Yes.
Are you part of it?
Yes.
Okay. Now let me ask you something. I heard that many of the corporate sponsors of these events are oil companies, Wall Street companies, Walmart, McDonald's, companies that have a controversial reputation. What do you think of that?
I mean, I think there's many companies in the U.S. who have a lot of different controversial situations, and there's companies that actually do outreach. So I think part of that is sort of sponsoring events like this and actually showing the community that it's not just sort of what's out in the media negatively.
Okay, now, what is the word Hispanic, the meaning of it?
See, I don't use the term Hispanic because I think it was created by the Office of Management and Budget. I use the term Latino. It's more grassroots. To me, I'm not anybody's panic, his or hers, and I'm also not anything created or imposed upon me. So I don't use that.
And what is the meaning of the word Latino?
To me, the meaning of the word Latino is something that we've chosen to call ourselves as a solidarity amongst the community and an experience that's here in the United States. Latino doesn't exist in our countries, it only exists here.
Right, but it comes from the word Latin, which is European.
Mm-hmm.
What about the other heritages that we might have? Let's say.
Yeah, I think in Latino culture there is a repression of your African roots and all those other roots. I didn't grow up that way, so I don't subscribe to that, but I think Hispanic, that term sort of distances it more from the African roots than Latino.
And when is it going to be stopped? I mean, the Congress members use it, the U.S. government use it, the corporate America use it. When is that going to change?
Unfortunately, I think this country is really, really, really focused on labels. They like to put people in categories because that's how they allocate money. And I think if we sort of decide amongst ourselves, that's when it sort of will be eradicated.
In 2010, the national census will take place. What would you mark?
Would you mark
Hispanic, African American, Native American, mixed?
Honestly, I do it by what community I feel needs it the most of the time. Lately, I've been checking black a lot because I do have a lot more phenotypically African roots. I don't walk down the street and people think, okay, she's white, you know? So it depends. For me, it's a political choice.
Yes. And I personally would mark American Indian,
right?
Because I have Peruvian indigenous roots.
Right.
And when I talk about this to some people, they get offended because they think it's dividing the community. You think this kind of topics divide our community?
I think people need to realize that it's not necessarily, it's a structure that's created to divide us. And I think that if they take it as more of a political stance and don't let that divide social issues, I'm Puerto Rican, so citizenship is not an issue for me, but I will sit there and I will fight with my Latino brothers and sisters for immigration and undocumented workers because I think it's an issue that matters.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you.
What is your identity, yourself? How do you define yourself, your ethnicity?
Well, I live on Capitol Hill, and I'm Hispanic descent.
Okay.
So this is all Hispanic professionals.
What is Hispanic?
For
that's
me?
What I don't understand. What is Hispanic?
The definition?
Uh-huh.
Somebody who works hard. You know, we're very appreciative of whatever.
Yeah, no, but what's your heritage?
My parents are from Ecuador.
Okay, and all your ancestors are from Spain? Is that what you're trying to say? All
Ecuador.
Your ancestry?
Ecuador.
Yeah, but Ecuador is not Spain. Why do you call yourself Hispanic?
I didn't call myself Hispanic.
Okay, so you're not Hispanic?
No, I'm Ecuadorian American.
Right, but what's your race?
My race?
You never thought about it?
Yeah. My parents are from Ecuador, and they're mestizo, you know, half Spaniard, half Ecuadorian,
indigenous.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, and why don't we in the U.S. value our indigenous heritage?
Oh, I do.
You do?
It's up to their family, bringing up traditions and values, and I definitely do. The music, the culture, the tradition.
But do you think the word Hispanic?
Well, it comes from Hispaniola.
That's true. Yeah. It means Spain.
There's a lot of this Hispanic, Latino, Spanish, there's different names.
Uh-huh. It's all that European heritage that is valued by Latino, Hispanic. But when are we going to actually value our native heritage?
Oh, I'm all about that. Yeah. I don't know, so for people to to bring that up into clarity.
Okay, awesome. And now you say you work at Capitol Hill. Okay, do you believe the Obama administration is actually going to approve an immigration reform?
Yeah, I hope so.
And you are an attorney, you say. Do you believe the Obama administration is actually going to pass an immigration reform?
I don't know. I was disappointed in the Institute caucus yesterday. I think it was yesterday that they discussed it. Because they talked about how difficult it's going to be if we don't do it now. The more time that passes, the more difficult it will be to pass. But I didn't hear any real strategies or outline of how we're going to move it forward and get it done. And I was hoping to hear more of that, especially from our congressional leaders, because it is a hot topic. But you don't deal with hot topics without having some kind of action plan. And I was disappointed I didn't hear that.